There's a very serious side to the celebrations as well, trying to get women involved in different careers. STEM is, of course, the one they're talking about. That's the sciences. And I had a chance to talk to one woman who is bringing about change, going after getting the young girls involved at a very young age so they continue it on throughout their lives.
Why is it so important to get them when they're, you know, is it preschool we're talking that you want to get them interested in science to keep them going in that direction?
As early as possible, I think, because at that point, everything, if you talk to a child, everything is possible. There's no biases yet, and if you show them that it is possible to be successful with a career in STEM, I think that will go a long, long way. But like I was saying, we have to sustain that mentorship, that encouragement.
And that's what Pueblo does, right? It helps the younger girls and gets them interested in it, and through the teachers, right?
Yes, so we travel around the world since 2011. We've trained over 2,500 teachers. This is in collaboration with the Ministries of Education. And also we have programs here in Toronto, and we're quite excited that we're going to be starting a program with the indigenous community where we could actually connect students in university, so young women, young students that are pursuing a career in STEM, and come and help us teach in those communities. So now you've got this peer-to-peer mentoring that we want to foster as well.
And with Pueblo throughout the world, are you starting to see results? It's been going for 8 years, so some of these girls are getting into high school, graduating as well. What kind of changes are you seeing?
Yeah, so we're getting reports from teachers that we are training, that their students are more engaged in class, and there's some sign that because of how good these teachers have been teaching in their classrooms, a lot of their students are pursuing science and engineering careers.